Hi.
Welcome.
I just...
Oh, Chair Lopez, you are on mute.
Hi. Okay. We're going to go ahead and get started this lovely afternoon here. Let's see. Today is May 16th, 2022. It is approximately 12:08. This is the executive committee meeting of the East Bay Community Energy. We have a short agenda where there will be no public presentations for information or for consensus today. Instead, we'll be moving into a closed session, and that'll be the corpus of our meeting. However, we do have a member of the public, so welcome, member of the public. So we'll go ahead and start with roll call.
Okay. And any of you would like to give me, for me to give the opening AB 361 statement? Great, thank you. This executive committee meeting is being conducted pursuant to the provisions of the Brown Act to facilitate teleconferencing and to reduce the risk of COVID-19 transmission of public meetings. Ordinarily, the Board Act sets strict rules for teleconferencing. AB 361 suspends some of those rules during a state of emergency where state and local health officials have recommended social distancing. The Brown Act continues to require that we notice meetings in advance and allow the public to participate. The EBCE Executive Committee has met all the applicable notice requirements, and the public is welcome to participate in this meeting. If you wish to be recognized during public comment, please fill out a public comment speaker form and use the raise hand feature in Zoom. You'll be recognized for 2 minutes. Comments can also be submitted online at ebce.org/meetings.
Thank you, and go ahead with roll call.
Great, thank you. Member Ariola. Member Ariola. Member Cobb.
Here.
Thank you. Member Martinez.
Here.
Thank you. Member May. Member May. Chair Lopez.
Present.
Thank you. We have a quorum.
Thank you very much. Oh, we do have a member of the public here and was wondering if you would like to go ahead and do public comment.
Sure. Mr. Kelly, I'll recognize you for 2 minutes.
Thank you. You know, in the past, I've been speaking about the generation rates for Bright Choice and the emissions intensity of the same product. And I don't feel like I'm making any headway here, but I do have another issue on the generation rates that I wanted to bring to your attention. And that is, ever since EBCE was founded, we guaranteed a discount from PG&E based on PG&E's generation rates. If you look at our published rates today, you will see that EBCE's generation rates are 3.5% higher than PG&E. Now, I dug into it a little bit and I found that starting in January, PG&E is also charging its bundled customers a PCIA charge. And as it turns out, that PCIA charge is higher than the one charged to EBCE customers. So apparently what staff have done is they've combined generation and PCIA to indicate that they've discounted the product by 1%. That isn't the way it's supposed to be. It's never supposed to have been that way. If you calculate the savings or the cost to EBCE customers based on the way that formula is developed, you will see that Bright Choice customers are paying millions of dollars more than they should. Now, I'm starting to give up on this public comment and input thing because no one ever really responds to it. And I think the reason is that the board does not require it. And I would like you to require the staff to go ahead and formulate an analysis on rates and emissions intensity that compares us to all the other CCAs in Northern California so that you can make a good decision. about where those rates and emissions should go. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your comment. There are no other attendees in the room. I'm going to go ahead and request, Tom, if you could put your contact information in the chat, and I'll have the clerk mark that down and ask that a staff member get back to you to explain what the rates look like and why they are as they are, and to provide clarification. And then we will go from there to see if there's any further steps that are needed in terms of providing this the same information generally to the public via an information item.
Great.
Is that possible?
Yes.
Okay. And so he's able to provide his information in the chat?
I have the information.
Okay, great. So we'll do that, and that way we could, you know, we could be sure that we're being responsive to the public. Okay, we're going to go ahead and move on to the next agenda item, which is going into closed session. So for that, the e-board has a different set of credentials to log into. So we'll be coming off of this one and going into closed session. And then I will come back and report out if there's any need to report out. Actually, our general counsel would do that. And then we would look to see if anyone would like to. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and take item five now. Would anybody, any member of the committee, like to request or place an item for a future board agenda? You could just raise your hand. Okay, so we've gotten five out of the way, so there will be no need for the other committee members to come back for me to adjourn the meeting. Okay. All right, so we'll go ahead and close this one up and we'll be back. Thank you.
Hey there.
Will you be joining closed session later?
I'm a panelist. I think see. I'm joining right now.
Okay.
This is the panelist link you sent me.
Oh, there is a closed session link. That's a panelist for the open session. The closed session is a meeting, so there is there's a separate email that you should have received that will give you access to that closed session. I can send it to you again if you like. I'm sending it to you.
I'm going right in.
Great, thank you.
Irene, we're coming back into open session.
Great. Okay, thank you. I'll monitor people of the attendee.
Okay, we have. Can you move? Can you promote Ender, please?
Thank you, Adrian.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. We are recording. So this is Chair Lopez of the Executive Committee. We're coming back out of closed session into open session. And we are on agenda item 4, General Counsel report out of closed session.
Oh, Madam Chair, I'd be happy to make that report. Direction was given to labor negotiators. There is nothing further to report. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We've already gone through item 5, so we are on item 8, and that is the adjournments. We are at 1:25. Thank you.
Great. Thank you very much.